The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, second chapter, text number 13, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on April 14th, 1973, in Los Angeles.
Deena Sinjata Dehi Kaumanam Jobanam Jara तथा देहांतरम प्राप्ति वीर सत नमय. This is a statement by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Bhagavan Ubhaj. Yes, you are not this body. The first instruction for spiritual understanding is to know that I am not this body. This is the beginning. The so-called yogis, they are exercising the body, studying the psychology of the mind by charts, by so many humbugs. But our philosophy is that we are not this body. And where is the question of exercising the body and spiritual realization? If I am not this body, then how I can realize myself simply by some gymnastic process? So, this is the mistake. The kurmis, jnanis and the yogis. The kurmis, pretty worker, materialistic person, they want bodily comforts. Their only idea is how to get the best comfort of this body. This body means the senses. We have got eyes, ears, nose, mouth, tongue, hands, genital, so many senses we have got. So as soon as we are in the bodily concept of life, immediately the necessity is for sense. But Krishna says to Arjuna that you are not this body. So therefore, my self-interest does not depend on my bodily comforts. They do not know this. Everyone at the present moment in this age, they are only businesses how to gratify the senses. The Western countries, they have got little information, but in India, there was cultivation of all kinds of philosophy. The atheist philosophy was there. Charvaka Muni is the chief of the atheist class of philosophers. So he said hedonism. The Western philosophy is hedonism. That eat, drink, be merry and enjoy. This philosophy. So long you have got this body, eat, drink, be merry and enjoy. The Charvaka Muni also said like that. Rinam kritya ghritam pive. In India, bodily enjoyment means first tongue. Tongue's enjoyment everywhere, here also. Tongue's enjoyment. So, if we want to control our senses, therefore, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, following the footsteps of previous acharya, he says that control your tongue. Control your tongue. And in the Bhagavata also it is said, Atat Sri Krishna Namadi Navabed Grayam Indriyai. Without these blunt senses, we cannot understand Krishna. It's not possible. These senses are so imperfect that you cannot acquire any perfect knowledge, material or spiritual, by these senses. That is not possible. Atha, even if you cannot know perfectly the affairs of this material world, just like they are studying the moon planet, the nearest planet. Besides this moon planet, there are millions and trillions of other planets. They cannot say anything. Because the senses are imperfect. How you can understand? I can see, say, up to 1 mile. But when there is question of millions and trillions of miles, how you can use your senses and have the perfect knowledge? So you cannot have even material knowledge perfectly by using these senses. What to speak of God and spiritual knowledge? That is beyond, avang manasa gochara, beyond your conception. Therefore Shastra says, Atha Sikrishna Namadi Namhavi Grayam Indriyai. If you want to know God by mental speculation, that is frog philosophy, Dr. Frog, calculating Atlantic Ocean, sitting down in the well. This is called frog philosophy. You cannot understand. Then, how it is possible to understand? The next line is, Sevanamukhe hi jivhado swayame vasudam. If you employ your tongue in the service of the law, he will reveal himself to you. He will reveal. Revelation. So therefore, we have to control the tongue. What is the tongue's business? The tongue's business is taste and vibrate. So you vibrate in service of the Lord, Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna means, O Krishna, O the energy of the Lord, kindly engage me in your service. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. This is the meaning of Hare Krishna. It has no other meaning. O my Lord Krishna, and O the energy of Krishna, Radharani especially, kindly, both of you engage me in your service. As Narsimhadas Thakur says, Haha Prabhu Nanda Suto Vrishabhanu Suta Juto. My Lord Krishna, you are well known as the son of Nanda Maharaj, and your eternal consort, Radharani, she is also known as the daughter of King Vrishabhanu. So both of you are here. Aha Prabhu Nanda Suta Vrishabhanu Suta. Koruna Karaha Eva. Now I have come to you. Please, both of you, be merciful upon me. This is Hare Krishna. Be merciful upon me. Narottama Dasa Kahe Nathariya Dangapaya. You are lotus feet, young God. Don't neglect me or push away with your lotus feet. I think if Krishna kicks and pushes away, that is our great fortune. You see, if Krishna kicks with his lotus feet, go away, that is also great fortune. What to speak of accepting? Just like when Krishna was kicking on the hood of the Kaliya. So the Kaliya's wife prayed, my dear sir, I do not know this culprit, Kaliya, how he became so fortunate that his hood is being kicked by you. Your touch of lotus feet, great guest, says a centric personage, trying to meditate upon millions of years, but this Kaliya, I do not know, what did he do in his past life that he is fortunate that his hood is being kicked by you? Or this is our position, that we cannot understand Krishna by our mental speculation, limitation. That is not possible. We have to engage. Sevanmukhi hi jiva do. Beginning from jiva, from tongue. Tongue is the greatest enemy, and it is the greatest friend also. If you allow the tongue to do whatever it likes, smoking, drinking, eating meat and this and that, then it is your greatest enemy. And if you do not allow the tongue, you can control the tongue, then you can control all the senses. Automatically. Tar madde jubhavati lobhomaya sudurumati tare jeta kochina samishare Krishna varo dayamaya kuribare jubhaja saprasad anna dila bhai shai prasad anna pao Radha Krishna Gunaga Premidako Chaitanyata. The tongue should be used always for glorifying the Supreme Lord. That is our business, the tongue. And the tongue should not be allowed to anything except Krishna Prasad. Then you become liberated. Simply by controlling the tongue. And if you allow the tongue to do anything, then it is very difficult. So the spiritual education, as Krishna said, begins when you understand that I am not this body, and satisfying the senses is not my business. Because I am not this body. If I am not this body, why shall I bother myself to satisfy the body only? Body means the senses. This is the first need. So the karmis, jnanis, yogis, they are all trying to satisfy the demands of the body. The karmis are directly doing that. Eat, drink, be merry and joy. That is their pleasure. Jnani is also, he is simply trying to understand that I am not this body. Neti, 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 neti. This is not, this is not, this is not, this is not. The yogis, they are also trying to come to the point of controlling the senses by bodily exercise. What is it? So their center of activity is body. Center of activity is body. And our philosophy begins that you are not this body. When they will pass their MA examination in studying this body, then they may be able to understand what is their function. But our philosophy begins that you are not this body. Postgraduate study. You are not this body. That is Krishna's instruction. We have seen so many big, big politicians and scholars in India. They write comments on Bhagavad Gita, but they write on this bodily concept of life. We have seen in our country, the great leader, Mahatma Gandhi, his photo is in some Bhagavad Gita. But what did he do throughout his whole life? The bodily concept. I am Indian. I am Indian. Nationalism means that's bodily concept of life. I am Indian, I am American, I am Canadian. But we are not this body. Then where is the question of I am Indian, I am American, I am Canadian? So they have no this knowledge. The bodily concept of life, they have absorbed and is still there. Authority of Bhagavad Gita. Just see the fun. And Bhagavad Gita teaches in the beginning, you are not this body. And they are in the bodily concept of life, that just try to understand what is their position. What they can understand Bhagavad Gita. If one is feeling that I belong to this nation, I belong to this family, I belong to this community, I belong to this cult, I belong to this, I belong to this religion. Everything is bodily concept of Lord. The yogi is there also trying to understand by bodily exercise. The jnani is also trying to know, understand fully that I am not this body. And the kormis, they cannot understand. They are as animals. The animals cannot understand that he is not body. Factually, the kormis, jnanis, yogis are a little maybe elevated than the animals, that's all. They are on the animal platform, but it is little elevated. So I give this example, perhaps you heard it, that the dry side of this tomb. India, they pass through on the open field. So, at the end of the day, because there is sunshine, the upper side of this tomb becomes dry. And the lower side is still moist. So somebody said, this side is very good. He does not know, it is tool after all. And this side or that side. So these rascals, they are on the bodily concept of life and they are thinking that I am nationalist, I am yogi, I am this, I am that, I am that. This is the case. So long you are in the bodily concept of life, you are no better than the animal. That is the Bhagavad philosophy. You are animal. Jashyatma buddhi kunape tridhatuke. Jashyatma buddhi kunape tridhatuke. Sadhik kalatra disubhomayijyadhi. Jatirtha buddhi salilena karhiche janesu avigyesu saeva gokhara. So, gokhara means, go means cow, khara means ass, animal. So who is that? Jashyatma buddhi kunape tridhatuke. This bag of tridhatu, kapha pitta bali. If one thinks that I am this body, I am this body. And in body relation, because in body relation I have got my family, society, children, wife, country, and therefore they are mine. So this sattva buddhi kunapi tidha. Sadhi. Sadhi means thinking they are mine. I am God. Sadhi kalatradishu. Kalatra means wife. Through wife we get children, we expand. The Sanskrit word is stri. Stri means expansion. I remain one. As soon as I get wife, I get become two, then three, then four, then five, like that. That is called stri. So, our expansion, These expansions, this material expansion, bodily expansion means illusion. Jalasya mohoyam ahamameti. This illusion increases. That I am this body, and in bodily relation, everything is mine. Ahamama. Ahang means I, and mama means mine. So long one shall remain in the bodily concept of life, his illusion will increase. It will never decrease. Therefore, the first instruction of Krishna to Arjuna, Arjuna would not have been in that position of illusion, that I am this body, and the other side, my brother, my grandfather, my nephews, they are all my relations. How can I kill? This is illusion. Therefore, to dissipate this illusion, darkness, Krishna began the first lesson that you are not this body. Deenasmin yathadehi kaumara jovanamira tathad dehantram prapti. You'll have to change this body as you have already changed. You are a baby, you change your body to child, you change your body to man, you change your body to youth, you change your body to old man. Now, after changes of it, as you have already changed so many times, similarly, there is another change. You have to accept another body. Very simple logic. You have already changed. So, tatha dehantram prapti dhiras tatva namayati. So, don't be afraid that your nephews and grandfather or guru and they die. They will not die. Change the body. That. So, namayati dhira. Dhira means sober, whose brain is nice, cool brain. One should not be bewildered when there is change of body. But the point is, Krishna says that tathat dehantram prapta, another change. That is, sober, one who is sober, he will think, then what kind of body I am going to get next? That is the problem. But these rascals, they do not know. Still, they are proud of their intelligence. He does not know for what kind of body he has come to this body and what he is going to get next body. They have no intelligence. Even they said that suppose if you get next body, dog's body, they say, what is the harm? Yes? In Hawaii University. One student says like that. His student is being educated, but he doesn't care even if he is going to become a dog next life. This is the education. This is the education. And they are intelligent. Professor Kotowski said in Moscow, Shamiji, after finishing this body, everything is finished. You see, he is professor. And he is student. So this is the position of so-called professor, student, university, all rascals. This is our challenge. All rascals. Because they are in the bodily concept of life, and this body. And the body has no change. But he's changing, he's seeing, actually, in this life, still he will not believe that after changing this body, I'll get another body. It is very logical. Deenasmin yathadehi kumara jovanam jara tatha dehantram prapti. Exactly in the same way, as you have changed so many times this body, I will have to change. Therefore, one who is intelligent, he should try to understand that what kind of body I am going to get next. That is it. So that is also explained in the Bhagavad Gita. What kind of body you can get. Janti deva vrata devan, pitrim janti pitri vrata, bhuteja janti bhutani. Madhyarinopi janti ma. If you want to go to the higher planetary system where demigods live for hundreds and thousands and millions of years, just like Brahma. Brahma has one day, you cannot call it calculate. So in higher planetary system, you have got thousands and thousands of better facilities for sense gratification and duration of life, everything. Otherwise, why the Kurmis, they want to go to the heavenly planet? So, Janti, Devabhratar, Deva. So if you try to go to the higher planetary system, you can go. There is process. Just like for going to the moon planet, one must be very expert in the karma kanda, creative activities. By karma kanda, you get by the resultant action of your pious activities, you can be promoted to the moon planet. That is mentioned in the Srimad Bhagavatam. But you cannot enter moon planet by your this process, by force itself go with this aeroplane and jets and Sputniks. That's not possible. Suppose if I have got a nice motor car in America, if I want to enter in another country forcibly, is it possible? No. You must get the passport, visa, you must get sanction from the government, then you can enter. Not because that you have got a very good car, you will be allowed. So, we cannot by force. This is foolish attempt, childish attempt. They cannot go. Therefore, nowadays they stop. They do not speak. They are realizing their failure. In this way, you cannot. So, but there is possibility. You can go. If you adopt the real process, you can be promoted. Similarly, you can go to the Pithri Logas by offering sraddhas and pinda. You can go to the Pithri Logas. Similarly, you can remain in this loka, bhutejya. Similarly, you can go back to home, back to God. So, who is intelligent? If you ask, what is the benefit by going to the planet, back to home, back to Godhead. That is assured in the Bhagavad Gita. Mām upetta kauntiya dukkhālayam masāsatam nāpnuvanti. If you come to me, then you won't have to accept again this material body, which is full of miserable conditions. He will remain in your spiritual body. So our Krishna consciousness movement is meant for allowing, elevating all living entities. Of course, it is not for all. It is very difficult. But anyone who has accepted this Krishna consciousness movement, if he follows the principle, then he is surely going to home, back to God. That is that. But if you deviate, if you become attracted by Maya, that is your business. But we are giving you information. This is the process, the simple process. Chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, be purified, remain always liberated from material classes. Takta Deham. Mamupesa, janma karma medibam jujanati. If you simply try to understand Krishna, then takta deham, after quitting this body, mom is. He will come to me. You try to realize and preach this kind for the benefit of the whole world, then everyone will be happy. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.